In this video, we are going to see about the combinational logic circuits. Basically, there are two types of logical circuits. One is combinational logic circuits and another one is sequential logic circuits. In this class, we are going to see about the combinational logic circuit. So what is a combinational logic circuit? Its output is dependent at all times on the combination of its inputs only. Okay, and it has no memory. A combinational logic circuit, its output depends on its input at any time. So whatever is the input at that point, what is the input, based on that the output will be. It will not carry over the previous circuits combinations. Okay, and it doesn't have any memory, so it's a memoryless. It can be defined as a digital logic circuit in which the output depends on the combination of inputs at that point of time with total disregard to the past state of the input. So whatever may be the past state of the inputs, what is the current state of the inputs, based on that only the output will be there. So whereas a sequential logic circuit, it has memory. Okay, so it can store the previous state, and whenever there is a clock signal taking place, it can store the previous state of the input and it can change the output. That is the main difference between a combinational logic circuit and sequential logic circuit. Example for combinational logic circuit is we can take a basic gates, NAND, AND, OR, etc. Whereas for sequential logic gates, we can take it as a flip-flops, where it can store informations and that informations can be passed during the next clock pulse only. So it's like that. Sequential logic circuit has memory. So what are all the characteristics of combinational logic circuits? As I said, at any instant of time, the output of the combinational circuits depends only on the present state, okay, of the inputs. Doesn't have any backup or memory. It don't have any memory to store the output. The n number of inputs and m number of outputs are possible in combinational logic circuit. We'll come to this point later. They can be made from basic logic gates like NAND, NOR, NOT, AND, OR, etc. There are three ways of specifying the function of a combinational logic circuit. You can specify them using a Boolean algebra, truth table, and a logic diagram. Some of the combinational logic circuit examples are half adder, full adder, half subtractor, full subtractor, multiplexer, demultiplexer, decoders, and encoders. We are going to see one by one. First, we will see half adder. Half adder is a basic building block of adding two numbers. You know, arithmetic logic unit is there in our central processing unit. So how it will do the arithmetic? We have seen using AND gate, you can multiply two numbers. That is 0 into 0, 0, 1 into 0, you have 0, etc. But when I want to add two numbers, for that also we have OR gates. But what will happen if you have 1 plus 1? What will happen to that? It has to generate 1, 0, isn't it? I'll show you. Now, if you take this, let's say for this combination, 0 plus 0, when you add these two, you get a 0. Then 0, 1, when you add, you get 1. Okay. Same way, 1, 0, you get answer 1. But when you add 1 and 1, what will happen? You will be having 0 and then 1 as a carry. So, how to generate this? Whereas an OR gate, what will be the output of an OR gate? 1 plus 1, you have truth. It will say only the combinations. If both inputs are 1, you will have a true output. That's all. But how will you add like this? So in that case, just using one single OR gate may not be useful. So that is why we go for the adder circuits. So here, half adder is a basic building block of adding two numbers so that it produces a when you add two numbers, say for example 1 plus 1, it generates the output as 0 and a carry. So it is used for doing that. Then only this carry can be given to the next number, and then we can add further numbers. So half adder is a basic building block of adding two numbers. It consists of two inputs and produce two outputs. So what we are going to see in half adder is just addition of two numbers, two single digit number. Okay, not more than that, not 4 bits or 8 bits, just 2 bits. Okay, we are going to see how to add. So here, let us say this is an input, one bit, this is another bit. When you add these two, it will generate a sum and carry. Say for example, here 1 and 1, then the sum will be 0 and carry will be 1. That is what we are going to see how this is going to generate. So it is used to perform OR operation of two single bit binary numbers. So what is the equation for this? You can see the equation for the sum is x bar y plus x y bar, which is similar to our XOR gate. Then carry, which is x into y. So using an XOR gate and an AND gate, you can build an half adder. So when you give, say for example, this is the truth table of these two equations, because for sum you have to put separate, for carry you have to put separate, because it will generate a sum and carry. Let us say the combinations A and B 0, 0. When it is both are 0, 0, what happens? Sum also will be 0, carry also will be 0. That is what given here. Then when you have A 0, here 0 and here 1. What will happen? Addition, when you add, sum will be 1, but there will be no carry. Okay, it will not produce any carry. There is no overflow, isn't it? So carry will be 0. Then 1 and 0, this is 1 and this is 0. There also you will have sum as 1 and there will be no carry. Whereas when you add 1 and 1, you will have 0 as a sum and 1 as a carry, as we have seen here. Yes, 1 plus 1, sum. When you are adding, you have the sum as 0 and carry as 1. Say for example, let me take a numerical value. 9 and 7, what will you do? 9 plus 7, it is 16. So here you will put sum as 6 and carry as 1. Okay, this will be the carry, isn't it? So 9 plus 7, you have 6. 16 is the answer. But to that digit, respective digit, you will put 0 and you will put 1 as a carry. Suppose I have here 1 and here 2. What will you do? You put carry here and then you will add all these things, isn't it? 2, 3, 4. Now you will have here 4. So this will be your answer. So likewise here we are adding. Suppose we have 1 and 0 here. What will happen? This one will you will put here. Just like how we put this one here. So now you add these two. 1 plus 1, it is again 1, 0. So here it comes 0 and there will be carry for this digit. So likewise you have to do for binary addition also. This already we have seen how to do that. So now that is what we are doing here. When you check the input, these are all the input. And when you check the output, respective output, you can see this is similar to our XOR gate. So when there is an odd number of ones, you get output as 1. When there are even number of ones, you get 0. So for this, you can use an XOR gate to build. And carry, it is similar to our AND gate, isn't it? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. When there is two ones, both are ones, you have out. So we can build an AND gate. So carry, you can build it with an AND gate, and sum, you can build it with an XOR gate. That is what the equation is also showing us. Now, so these are the input. Likewise, you have to build. So A and B, when you give A, B, this is the XOR gate. Now you can check your output. So when you give both 1, your sum will be 0 and carry will be 1. When you give the different combinations, the carry is 0 and the sum comes when there is a single 1 in the input. Now we go for full adder. Half adder is used for adding only two numbers. Then what will happen to a full adder? Say for example, why we go for a full adder? See here, we are adding only two numbers. Okay, so 1 plus 1, 0, and you have what? You have a carry 1. Now I have another number, right? Now this digit is also there. In that case, I'll put this 1 here, right? I have entered this 1. Right. Now, what happened? What will happen? Now we have to add three digits. 1, 1, 1. 3 bits you have to add simultaneously. In that case, this hop adder may not be useful because we have only 2 inputs, isn't it? We have only A and B. We need 1 more input to be passed. So in that case, this hop adder may not be useful. So what we do is we go for the third, that is our next one called full adder, where it can add 3 bits. So A, B, and carry in. What is carry in? This is the carry in. Carry from the previous digits. So that we have to add. So for that, we go for full adder. So this will be also considered as a third input. Now, we as usual, we have to find the sum and carry. Now, when you see this, see here, the inputs. When A is 0, B is 0. Then C is also 0. You have sum and carry 0. When this is 0, this is 0, 1. Let me show you that using a jump. See here, when A is, let us say this as A and this as B and this is carry in, okay? 0, 0, you have, sorry, this also 0 because the first, there is no carry here. So 0, 0. Now let us consider the next one, 0, 0. Actually, I have to put the carry here. Now, when I say that, let us consider previously there are some digits and there is a carry 1 here. Now, when you say here 1 plus 0 plus 0, you have 1 as the answer. Here, there is no carry. Okay. So, the carry is 0 here and sum is 1. That is what we are seeing here. See, the sum is 1 and there is no carry. Then, 1, 0, 0. Now we'll see this.